Hello and welcome to everyone. I am Desh Deepak. Today in this video session, we'll be learning about email migration from any webmail clients to Microsoft Office 365 platform. So let's see how we will do that. So before we move with the migration, we'll have to make ourselves available with the prerequisites for this demonstration. So the prerequisites are the admin console access of webmail client and the Microsoft Office 365, the username password for each email users in webmail client, and the username and password for each emails in Microsoft Office 365 that will be specifically used for the testing purpose if the emails are migrated successfully or not. So let's move with the major steps, and main steps for the webmail client would be the emails user needs to be created, that needs to be migrated, and those email users need to have some emails inside it that needs to be migrated to the Office 365. Okay, so let's see what we have at our end. Okay, as you can see in my screen, I have Vesta installed into my web server. So Vesta is an open source hosting platform. So I have used it, and I have created a web domain and named cloudhelper.tk, and I have hosted multiple records over here. So you can see multiple records are present over here. And if I go to the mailing section, that is the section that we'll be looking into, it has two accounts. If I click into that, there is two accounts. One says deepak@cloudhelper.tk. And another user is this@cloudhelper.tk. So if I open my webmail and log in into it, okay, so I'm logged in into as this@cloudhelper.tk, as you can see at my right hand side of the browser. So in my user named this@cloudhelper.tk, I have three emails, and that says testmail1, testmail2, and testmail3, where testmail1 and 2 are unopened and testmail3 is opened. Okay, now if I similarly go to another user, that is deepak@cloudhelper.tk, that is over here. And here also similarly, I can see three emails, that is testmail4, testmail5, and testmail6. And these three emails are not even clicked at my end. So that's why it's showing a little bit of block type of content. Okay. So the main goal of our is to migrate these email addresses, that is 3 and 3, 6 email addresses, to Microsoft Office 365 platform. So our main goal is that one. So if we go over here and move with the part that needs to be configured at the Office 365 level. So the first step is to create or we can say verify a domain at Office 365 level that will create similar users that we have created in the webmail client, that is this@cloudhelper.tk and deepak@cloudhelper.tk. So let's see how we do that. Let me log in into my Office 365 console as admin. This is my admin center for my Office 365 account. You can log in into it using this URL that says portal.office.com. And once I'm inside it, I'll go to users. I'll go to active users. And I have already created two users similar to webmail. That is deepak@cloudhelper.tk, as you can see over here. And this@cloudhelper.tk, as you can see in the screen of mine. Okay, so fine. We have created two users. And if you want other users to be created, there are two options. One is manually, that is you need to click on add a user, give it a first name, last name, and other requirements, and just click next, and you'll be given easy to understand options. And configure those accordingly, and you will be able to create a new user. And for now, we'll cancel it. And if you want multiple users to be created once, then you will be using something like, let's say, yeah, this one. That is, says add multiple users. We'll click over here and you have to just follow a CSV file format and you will just include this information related to new users. And you can create multiple users in bulk. So we have only two users right now, so we'll move with the manual option. So we have created already two email users. And if I go over here, so create similar users at our Office 365 label has been completed. Now the next step is to create email migration task configurations to proceed with the migration. So let's see how we do that. So for that, I'll again go to my Office 365 admin console. I'll scroll down and go to Extensions. That says Extensions option over here. I'll click on that. And once I click on the Extensions option, it redirects me to the Extensions Admin Center. And once I'm inside my Extensions Admin Center, I'll go to Migration Options. That is over here. I'll click on Migration. And I'll click on Add Migration Batch. Click on Add Migration Batch, give Migration Batch a unique name. Let's give it a name, say Webmail to Office 365 Migration. Okay. And select the mailbox migration part, that is, we want to migrate to Extensions Online. So we'll be choosing that because we are migrating from Webmail to Office 365, not from Office 365 to other mailing portals. So we'll be choosing this option. Click on Next and select the migration type. And for now, we'll be choosing the IMAP migration type. Click on IMAP migration. Click on Next. And once you click on IMAP migration, it will result you in some prerequisites that need to be kept in your site that needs to be configured before we move to the next step. So let's see what it says. It says you create a user in Office 365 that we have already created. You need to add a domain. We have already added a domain also. We need to have a full name of the current email server. And we do have that one. And we'll be configuring that in the next step. And contain the list of mailbox. We'll also be looking into that in the next step, how we do that. So everything looks fine. We'll click on Next. Okay, so yeah, we don't have any existing migration endpoints. I'll click on Create a new migration endpoint. That will be acting as a connection settings for the server. That is Webmail server and the Office 365 mailing server that will be used for the migration purpose. Click on Next. Give the migration endpoint a unique name. Yeah. I'll giving it this name. Maximum concurrent migrations 20 and it looks fine. I'll go with the default one and the main important one comes over here. So I'll giving it a name, IMAP server name. And for now the IMAP server name of mine is mail. Dot cloud helper dot pk. Authentication basic, encryption none, because I haven't configured any sort of SSL and TLS for now, as the I'm using the test account. So encryption none, and for the non-encryption the IMAP port is 143 instead of 993. Okay, looks fine. I'll click on Next. And once you click on Next, it says that new endpoint has been created and it's been signaled with a green color. This simply means that our connection between Webmail and Office 365 mailing service or mailing servers has been created successfully and we can proceed with the further steps to proceed with the migration. Looks everything perfect till now. We'll click on Next. And once we click on Next, it shows a user option that says add user mailboxes. And if you see over here, it says migrate from CSV file. And yes, we will have to create a CSV file including specific information. And we'll look into how we do that. And once the file is created, we'll browse and select that and move ahead with the migration steps. So let's see how we do that. So I have already created a CSV file. If we look into that, it says, okay. it says webmailoffice.csv, and there are three major fields that says email address, username, and password. So the email address part includes the email addresses of the Microsoft Office 365 that we have created. That is des@cloudhelper.tk and deepak@cloudhelper.tk. And the username section contains the email addresses of the webmail client that we have created in the Vesta, and the password of the username email addresses created while the creation of the webmail clients email addresses. So once this data has been pushed at your end, so currently I have only two email addresses to be migrated from a webmail client to Office 365. So I have pushed my data accordingly. So you can push your multiple email addresses over here and proceed with the migration steps. So yes, the file has been created and you need to save it as .csv. I have done it already. So I'll close it and browse that. Click on browse and go to downloads. I have that one. Yes, webmail.office. Click on that. I've selected, and once I have selected, you can see that there has been an option popped up and that says two successful users are ready to be migrated. So I'll click on next now. And once I click on next now, it says or provides us some migration filtering options. Select folders to be skipped or migrated, or we can say select items by time range. So in case if you have specific emails only that needs to be migrated based on the time frame, then you can select the time frame before, after, anything. So for now I don't want any of them. I want all of my mailboxes or mail email addresses from the old webmail client to be migrated from Office 365. So I'll not select any of them and click on next. And yes, once I click on next, I'll be redirected to the schedule batch migration option, and I'll click on my one of the admin email address. So once the migration completes, I'll be mailed with the output of the migration completed data. So here are three options that says manually start the batch later, automatically start the batch once I click on save, and start the batch automatically after a time. So for now I'll be choosing the automatically start the batch once I save it. So everything looks fine. I'll click on save, and once I click on save, it says batch creation in progress, please wait while we get it ready. Okay, let's wait for a few minutes, and once it's ready it has come up, batch creation successful. I click on done, and if we see over there that we have configured it successfully. So the webmail Office 365 migration name has appeared, and if we click on this one, and it says the migration details over here, type IMAP, direction onboarding, status is syncing. So the status syncing simply means that the mail migration is in progress, and once the mail migration completes, the status will change from syncing to synced. So if we want further details to be looked in, we'll click on this view details link. And it will say show us all the details related to email users. So des@cloudhelper.tk and deepak@cloudhelper.tk, the status is validating. And yes, data consistency store is empty for now. Item syncs 0, item skipped 0. So everything looks fine. So let's wait for a few minutes, and once the status changes from syncing to synced, then we'll come back and look into further steps that needs to be configured to complete this demonstration. Okay, so the status have been changed. So the status have been changed from syncing to synced. This simply means that our email migration from webmail client to Microsoft Office 365 has been completed. And if you see into further details, the data consistency store is perfect. The percentage synced is 100%, the total number of email users were 2, sync 2, and other specific details. Okay, so as the migration has been completed, let's check and log in into the Outlook with the specific details of Office 365 users to check if the emails has been migrated successfully or not. So let's quickly run down through that. I'll open my Microsoft Edge and let's log in into my Outlook account. And I log in as the email user created at the Office 365 int. So the user is this cloudhelper.tk, and let me push the password for it. And okay, as you can see that the emails has been synced at the Microsoft Office 365 label. So you get three emails already, and one of them has been checked out and two of them are been not checked out, as you can verify this at the Vesta webmail client end also. So if I go over here, you can see the user is this at the cloudhelper.tk, and there are three emails, and one of them is checked out, and other ones, two of them are not checked out. So this verifies that emails has been successfully migrated. Okay, so now what is the next step? So we have created email migration task configurations, and the migration has also been successfully completed. Now the final step is to update the MX record of Office 365. So that emails get sent and received from the Office 365 platform instead of the webmail, if the requirement of yours is like that. So let's do that one, how we will be looking into that. So for that, I'll go to my Vesta console. I'll click on my DNS records. I'll click on list at in records. And if we see over here, the MX record is of webmail, that is mail at the red cloudhelper.tk. I'll replace that one and set the priority to 0, and the value of it would be, okay, so what would be the value of it? So we can easily find that by going to Office 365 admin console, and if we go to home, okay, I'm at my home, and if we go to domains option, you can see over here that shows there are possible services or registration issues. I'll click on that. And if we go to my domain, that is cloudhelper.tk, there are possible service issues. I'll click on that. And if I go to DNS records, it says that the MX record hasn't been configured successfully and the status is showing error. So we need to add this value at the Office 365 level. So I'll copy the address value and point that to the Vesta console, and the priority is set to 0, the value is 0. I'll click on save, and once I click on save, the MX record of the webmail has been replaced with the MX record of the Office 365. This simply means that the mails now will be receiving at the Office 365 label instead of the webmail. So let's check if these records have been propagated successfully or not. We'll be using the DNS checker tool. If I check over here now, the email seems to be propagating slowly. So let me refresh this page once again. Okay, so this propagation will take few time, and once the propagation completes, the emails will be migrating to your Office 365 end. Okay, so this brings to the end of this demonstration and the learning phase, where we learned the email migrations from our webmail clients to Office 365. Hope it was useful at your end. In case if you have any further queries or any questions, feel free to reach to us at the comment sections. We'd be happy to help you, and thank you. We'll meet soon.